So today's video is featuring the Gilbert family. They lived here in Delmar, Iowa. There were six of the family members, the wife, and five children were all shot and killed by the husband. So I'll get into everything. It's a very sad but interesting story. So let's get into it. The date was January 3rd, 1981. Gene Gilbert, 28 years old, shot and killed his wife and their five children. Gene's wife was Bonnie Gilbert. She was 34, and their five kids were Rochelle, who was only 10 months old at the time. Gene Jr. Was 2 years old. Jason, who was 8, Michelle, who was 10, and Don, who was 13. Three of the kids were from Bonnie's previous marriage, but they all obviously lived together. All of them, again, were shot dead. The only person that seemed to have caused a struggle was the oldest child, Don, who was 13. Everyone else, they seemed like they were asleep when they were shot and killed, but Don must have been woken up by the shooting. After killing his wife and his five children, Gene drove approximately 450 miles up to South Dakota, where his father and brother lived. He hung out with his brother and father, seemingly normal. He didn't say anything, he didn't act any differently, and they weren't surprised that he was there unannounced, even though it was 450 miles away. Supposedly Gene would go up there randomly often because he was upset about something, or he just wanted to get away from the family for a while. So I guess it was normal for him to drive that far. So they're like, oh, hey, Gene's here, randomly out of the blue. But to them, it was no big deal. The only thing he really mentioned was that he wasn't feeling very well and that he hadn't slept very well. So the next morning, Guy and Guy Jr., brother and father of Gene, they left to go to a doctor's appointment. And so they left Gene in the house. When they returned, they found Gene dead with a gunshot wound to the chest, revolver, next to him, obviously apparent suicide. There also was a suicide note that Gene left. So background on the Gilberts, they moved to Delmar, Iowa here about 14 months prior to the murders. They apparently went to the church regularly. They went to school obviously here. The children's teachers noticed that the children were always seemingly sad or just not happy very much. One of Don's teachers got a note from Don and it just said that, like, thank you for loving me. So it kind of gives you a little insight into the family dynamics. I read also that Gene was a very, very strict disciplinarian. He apparently would ground the children for basically like the most minor things, and the groundings would last like potentially up to a week or even like a month. Gene had threatened to kill the family the summer before. Apparently they didn't take him seriously because no one called the police, no one did anything. Gene had lost his job at a pavement maintenance place a couple months prior to the murders. So he basically was supporting himself and the family on welfare checks. And Michelle, the 10-year-old, was also sick at that time, having to go to Iowa City Hospital quite frequently. Gene was never in the Vietnam War. He apparently went AWOL before he was forced to serve. This is the Gilbert residence. It was 206. Market Street. This is the house where they all died at. Well, except Gene, obviously. They all were found upstairs in their respective bedrooms. It's just, I don't know. So it's eerie when you see an old photograph of a crime scene, and then you can match it up with the actual house. And it was only like 40 years ago, 1981. Very small town, really small house. Driving around this small town, you would never know that something that tragic and that many murders happen in a house like this, unless you actually knew the story. Alright guys, I'm gonna head out of here. Thank you so much for watching. If you're new around here and you like crime-related content like this, where you see me explore different infamous cases, different crime scenes, missing person cases, all that kind of stuff. If you like that kind of stuff, definitely make sure you hit the subscribe button. and the little bell next to it. And yeah, if you like the video, a like is always appreciated. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. My name is Harmon, and I'll see you guys on the next one.